Happy Monday. Today I'm going to do our stretch video live from the fitness center. I wanted to go ahead and get on early. I was just going to post a video, but I wanted to actually make the stretch class. So whenever you do join in and join us for this stretch, make sure that you comment down below that you have logged in. Since the new format changed with our live feed, we're no longer able to see as you come in and join us. So it usually would show up in green in the chat box of who's joined on. So please, if you join on, even if it's just for a moment, make sure you comment to let us know that you did join on, even if you weren't able to stay to complete the entire stretch class. We have some exciting things happening this week. Our first thing you'll see in our Monday motivational that we have a combo class that Kayla and I will both be teaching, and it's going to be over Zoom. And you will log on to PTMinder and reserve your spot in that class. So further information coming on that today. Stay tuned for a post. Let's go ahead and start with our stretch class. We're going to start standing today. Most of these stretches can be done in a different modified format, either from a chair or from the floor. So if you're just not ready to stand up with me today, try to follow suit on the floor. We're going to start by feet are under the hips, hands are at the side, kind of setting the moment for the body. So I want you to feel grounded in the floor. Shoulders are down your back, chest is up, chin is forward, not lifting and not sinking towards the chest. Closing your eyes down just for a moment here. Listening to your breath, focusing on nice big inhales and exhalations. We're going to add our arms right here. Let's inhale those arms up over our head. Exhale the arms down. One more. Reach up nice and tall. Exhale the hands to the sides. Soften your knees. If you know that your hamstrings are extremely tight today, you're going to want to create a lot more bend in that knee. We're going to roll over slowly and fall into a forward fold. Again, we're just starting out. So if you need to, create space, bend those knees, rest the rib cage on the thighs, and just hang your head. If you're not starting out with really tight hamstrings or posterior side, take some of that bend out of the knee. We're just going to sink into this stretch, allowing those shoulders to give way from our ears, letting our torso collapse towards our thighs. If you have your knees bent, maybe take them to a soft knee now. If you feel like you're getting some stretch, some relief, I think you can push it a little further to your stretch. Release your hands to the floor. We're going to walk our hands over to the right side of the body and the foot. So your right hand is out to the right of the right foot. Left hand is reaching towards that right hand. So we're getting a deeper stretch on the right lower half of our body, but we're also getting a stretch now behind our left arm, maybe a little more in the lats. You want to turn your chest towards that left arm and away from the right leg, you'll get a further stretch down that rib cage, as well as maybe a little chest. Use that breath to sink into your stretch. Letting our breath guide us. We're going to walk back through the center. And now we'll reach over to the left. Allow your head to rest. So drop that head slightly. Reach over to that left side. Thank you. Lock the hands back to center. We're all going to take a big bend in our knees. Our chest, our stomachs, rib cage should be resting here on the thighs. And hang. Grabbing the opposite elbow, so my right's grabbing my left is grabbing my right. Push the elbows into your hands and feel that stretch in that upper back. Release the hands. We're going to come up to a flat back. Lifting through that chest, pull the shoulders away from the ears, and then drop it down gently. On your next inhale, we're going to come up all the way. Inhale up, reach those arms high above the head. Take a little mini back bend here if that feels appropriate for you. And bring those hands down to your side. Next stretch is a chest opener. If you have rotator cuff issues or any shoulder issues, then your option is going to be placing that hand on the wall and opening away from that direction. If not, if you have no shoulder issues, take both hands, place it behind the head, and then pull those elbows back as though you're trying to pull them together. So we're opening up through the chest. And then with the next time you inhale, I want you to bring those elbows towards each other, tuck them to the pelvis, and then stand back up and lift through those elbows. One more time. Inhale, elbows forward. Exhale. Take a mini back bend here if it feels okay. Still pulling those elbows back and release those hands and arms down. Couple shoulder rolls. We're gonna move to similar with our hands to the wall, but we're going to take the right back of our arm, not preferably not the elbow bone, the back of the arm, which would be the tricep region. Hands are behind the head. We're going to place that right tricep against the wall and then sink towards the wall. Now, this is an awkward one to get just right. Let's let that left hand go. So the idea, let me turn around, maybe get this angle, is that we're taking that right arm, placing it on the wall, dropping that armpit towards the wall, but notice I'm not touching. So we're not just here laying on the wall, we're actively sinking into that armpit. I feel this all the way from my tricep down through my lats. I'm even feeling a little bit of my erectors in my back. Move your head to a comfortable position for the neck. So no strain in the neck on this one. For my neck, I feel best with my chin pointing towards my right arm. One more breath. Exhale, come out of that slowly. Bring that arm down. Take both hands back behind. Interlace the fingers, lift through the chest. And release. Left arm, place that left hand back behind your head, or you can start with it on the lower part of your head. We're going to place it in the wall, place that left arm against the wall, and then drop our left chest towards the wall as though we're trying to touch our armpit, but not doing it. Two more breaths. Last one. And release. Come off of that wall. Interlace those fingers again. Squeeze those arms together. Lift through the chest. All right. We're going to move into a thoracic opener. Lengthener. Placing both hands on the wall, your feet are quite a ways from the wall to begin with. We'll probably move them forward. But I want to start in an easiest position. Hands are about shoulder width or a little further apart. Press the palm. palms into the wall and drop your chest down towards the floor. And this may be right where you want to stay, as long as you're feeling a nice chest opener and thoracic lengthening. I'm going to walk my feet in and I'm going to sink closer to the wall. Try not to crank through the neck and trying to look at the wall. Just allow your head to relax. You can even relax your forehead on the wall. Staying firm with those palms. You can soften the knees if you'd like, or you can keep them a little straighter, more than lengthening down the entire body. One more stretch here, or one more breath. Exhale all the way out. Bend the knees, slowly come out of this, bringing those hands down. If you're tight, you might feel a little cramp in that lower back. All right. We are moving into pigeon pose standing. You can always take this to the floor for original pigeon pose, or you can choose to do the number four stretch like this, laying on your back. All right, several options. I'm going to place my right hand on the wall. Taking my right ankle, let's place it over the left thigh. Make sure that your left knee is not diving forward. Sit back in that left heel and then lower to a position you find comfortable. I'm going to take the opportunity to stretch my right arm up while I sink my right hip and just trying to get a little extra stretch for that. Allowing that right hip to just sink. Chest is slightly forward. And a further advanced stretch would be to take that right hand towards the floor, allowing that chest to drop towards the right calf. Still sinking through that right glute and right hip. We have one more breath here. Release. Drop out of that stretch. Shake it about. Coming to the left side. Left hand is on the wall. Left ankle across that right thigh. I'm going to start with my hand on the wall. We'll see if we get to the floor on this side or not. And slowly just start sinking into that right heel and that left hip. And if you want to try sending the left hand towards the floor, I need a block today. I may just hold my left right leg. So it's much tighter. One more breath. And release. Whew. Goodness. All right. Find your way onto your mat if you have it. If not, I'll give you a second to place your mat close to the wall. If you have knee issues, this is what I would ask that you do. So instead of going into our wall stretch, you would lie down if you have any knee conditions, and you'll pull that top leg back. You could even use the wall to help assist you with that foot. But we're gonna stretch through the quads, the hip flexors here. So that'll be your choice. That is for people that maybe have knee discomfort and full flexion of the knee. I'm gonna start with my right knee back against the wall. Right foot is flat against the wall, and just stay right here for a moment. So as you sit here, pull those glutes down. So if you notice, I'll move through my hips right here, and I'm pushing my pelvis towards the floor right here. This may be where you want to stay today. I'm going to grab a block. Maybe you can grab your husband, child, book, and I'm going to try bringing that left foot forward. And I'm not going to stand upright just yet. Let's stand right here. Lifting through my chest, feeling that nice stretch in the front of the leg. If you can, you can try to stand all the way up. I would suggest using a book or block, and maybe you can hold yourself all the way up. I'm way too tight to hold without anything. And again, that's always an option to stay where we started. Push that pelvis forward with each exhalation. Allow that pelvis to sink towards that front foot. I'm going to release, bring my hands back to the floor, and walk that foot away from off the wall. Woo, that feels so good to release that. All right, left foot goes against the wall, my knee. Starting right here, foot is flat against the wall. Okay, right foot comes forward. I'm going to stay right here at first. So my right leg is in front of my body. I've got the weight in the heel of my foot. And I'll come up one more step onto my block, lifting through that chest. Give me two more breaths. If you want to try to come up to a more standing position or an upright position, not standing. One more breath right here, and we're going to come out of it. Exhale out. Hands come back to the floor. Ooh, good. Our next stretch is going to be downward dog. We are going to move through this. I want you to send one leg up the wall. That'll be the second part of the downward dog series. But first, make sure you've got enough room. Let's place our heels onto the floor and send our bottom back, dropping through our chest to our shins. You should be primarily out of the hands here. A lot of people find that if you're finding that downward dog is really difficult on upper body, then you're probably too tight to really sit back in those hips. Because I have very little pressure on my hands right now. Now I'm going to come forward slightly, and I'm going to get my right leg, and I'm going to place him against the wall, and then I'm going to go back to downward dog position. So you should feel a stretch. With this one, you'll feel the stretch. If you're able to place your left heel down, you'll feel a stretch in that left calf, as well as in the front of the right leg that's on the wall. Sink those shoulders towards that leg. And we're going to release. Come on down. Come off of your hands for a moment. Roll those shoulders. Setting up for our next leg. Get into position. We'll go to down dog first. Those heels down. Drop through that chest. We'll take one more breath right here in down dog. And then let's send that left leg up the wall. Mm-hmm.
Last breath, one nice deep breath in. Exhale all the way out, and let's bring both of those knees down to our mat. All right. We're going to move in through happy baby pose to get a little more in those hips, as well as some inner thigh stretch before we move to torso twist. All right. Let's go ahead and find yourself on your mat. I'll give you a moment to pull away from the wall, and we will lay slowly back. Okay, grab that right foot. If you can grab the big toe, we're going to pull that knee to the outside of the right side of our rib cage towards our armpit. If you can grab the center of the foot, even better. Some may stay with single leg. If you do so, I'll give you a time to switch. I'm gonna start with both, and I'm gonna pull those knees back. Allow those shoulders to sink, even though your hands are applying pressure. And I've lost my light because I need to look forward. You want to open the knees just a little bit from that deep flexion. You can create a little rock if that feels good. You have one single leg, now you need to switch and go to the other side. Pull those hands and feet back. Going to release, bring those feet down. We're going to drop our knees out to the right, sending that top leg out maybe a little further. Take your right hand, place it on that left hip, give yourself a little more tug and push there. Look over that left hand and just allow that left shoulder to fall towards the floor. Opening up that chest, creating more space in that chest. I'm going to release one knee at a time. Roll back through the center. Lift both knees up. Drop it to the other side. And then take that left hand, place it on that right hip. Look over the right hand, dropping that right shoulder towards your floor. Two more breaths here. Release, bring those hands back, or knees back, feet back to the floor. And move them right to left, just to let go of that back a little bit more. Our final stretch, let's just do a nice long stretch. Point those toes away from the head. Reach the arms over, pointing and pulling away. Imagine reaching the opposite sides of the room. And release everything to the floor. Letting that back relax. Let go of the feet and the legs and the hips, the arms, the head. Feeling amazing, right? After that.
Thank you guys for joining me today. Make sure to comment if you participated. Have a great Monday.